everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to be learning about geometric probability by relating it to simple probability from the previous lesson. When you think of geometric probability, think of areas, lengths, and angles, which are all topics that you've already learned about in this course. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to calculate geometric probability involving areas, lengths, and angle measures. First, we'll explore probability that involves area and complete an example. Next, we'll explore probability that involves lengths and complete an example there. And then we'll explore probability using angles and complete one final example. In the previous lesson, you learned how to calculate simple probability as the number of outcomes that meet the criteria over the total number of outcomes. This formula worked great when we had something like 15 marbles and 4 of them were yellow. Then we could say that the probability of drawing a yellow marble is 4 out of 15. But what if we have something like this? If I choose a point at random on this square and find the probability that it's in the blue shaded region, how many possible outcomes are there? And how many outcomes are in the shaded circle? Is there an exact number of possible outcomes that we can use to represent this? No, since we don't have an exact number of items that we're choosing from, like in our marbles example, where there were 15 marbles and 4 of them were yellow. This is why we use part that meets criteria over whole instead here. Then we just have to decide what our part and whole are for each geometric probability problem. In this particular problem, the whole thing is the total area, and the part that meets the criteria would become the area that meets the criteria. This leads us to our first example problem of geometric probability involving area. It says, a point is chosen at random in the square. Find the probability that it is in the shaded region. Write your answer as a decimal rounded to the nearest hundredths place. Here's the formula we had just come up with. Can you use this formula to find the probability of landing in the shaded region? Try it now. Well, the whole figure that we can choose a point on is the area of the square. And the part that meets the criteria of being in the shaded region is the area of the circle. The area of the circle is pi times r squared, with 3 being the radius. And the area of the square is 7 times 7. Now, we can simplify this fraction and keep our answer exact, but it is hard to tell from this how likely it is to actually pick a point in the shaded region. Plus, telling somebody that the probability is 9 pi over 49 is probably going to get you some funny looks. Instead, this would be better off rounded as a decimal. If you haven't already, type this expression into your calculator and get a decimal rounded to the hundredths place. You should have gotten 0.58. Let's see if this makes sense. 0.58 is almost 60%. Does it look reasonable that the shaded circle takes up close to 60% of the square? Yeah. Even if this wasn't drawn to scale, it's definitely not 90% or 10%. This seems reasonable, so we could be confident in our answer. Now let's talk about geometric probability involving length. Here's our geometric probability formula again. For area, we replaced this with the area that met the criteria over the total area. But what about a problem like this? This doesn't use area, and also it doesn't have a given number of options like the marble example did. So if a point is randomly chosen on this entire segment, and we want to know the probability of the point landing on segment AR, how would we figure it out? We would use length instead. This gives us the length that meets the criteria over the total length. This example says, a point is chosen at random on segment AB. Find the probability that it's on segment AR. Write your answer as a fraction. Here's our formula. Can you find the probability of choosing a point on segment AB that's also on segment AR? The length of the whole thing would be the length of segment AB, which is 8 plus 4 plus 6, or 18 units. Now, what about the part that meets the criteria of being on segment AR? That would just be 8 units. Okay, now what should we do? We were told to write our answer as a fraction, which is what we have, but our answer isn't reduced. This can be written as 4 over 9. Now let's talk about geometric probability involving angles. Here's that geometric probability formula again. We've adapted it to work with area as well as length. But what about a sector on a circle? If we choose a point at random on a circle, how could we find the probability of it being in the unshaded region? We want to figure out what part of the circle's central angle the unshaded sector takes up. Since a circle is divided into 360 degrees, we could just figure out how many of those 360 degrees the sector's central angle takes up. This allows us to adapt our formula to the angle that meets the criteria over the entire angle, or 360 degrees. Our example problem says, a point is chosen at random on the circle. Find the probability that it's in the unshaded region. Write your answer rounded to the nearest whole percent. Here's the geometric probability formula again. Go ahead and give this problem a try. Pause the video now. Did you realize that the whole angle measure is 360 degrees, since this is a circle? And the part that meets our criteria is the unshaded section, which can be calculated as the entire way around the circle minus the shaded part. This unshaded central angle measures 230 degrees. If you got stuck up to this point, give yourself a chance to finish this yourself and find the probability as a percentage. 230 divided by 360 gives us approximately 0.639. And multiplying that by 100 to get a percentage gives us approximately 63.9%. Then we can round that to a whole percentage of 64. Now you can calculate geometric probability. Our general formula for geometric probability can work for area, length, and angles for sectors in a circle. Good luck on your practice questions, and I'll see you next time.